welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, hey, if you aren't new here, thank you so much for coming back and watching another video. So in this video, I'm doing a get to know me Q&A. Basically asked my followers on Instagram, shameless plug right here, follow my Instagram if you want to keep up with day-to-day things and be more up to date on what I'm doing and stuff like that, at T the Kid on Instagram, double T, double D. I asked them basically if they had any questions for me, and I've been doing YouTube for like 3 years now, but I did take a long break, and during all of that, I still feel like people who have been subscribed to me, which thank you for staying subscribed, honestly, but I feel like people who have been subscribed to me still don't really know me that much. I've filmed this like 3 times, so hopefully 3rd time's the charm. So before we get started, if you want to hit that subscribe button, if at the end of this video you enjoy it, you want to see more, hit that like button and also hit that notification bell. Honestly, in this top, I feel like I'm on an episode of like Charm School, so I'm kind of feeling that a little bit. So before I get started with the questions though that my followers asked me, since those questions are a little more detailed, I did want to hit like some just baseline questions, just some easy ones to get started with, and then I'm gonna go on to the more detailed questions, which I love. So I googled get to know me Q&A question. How tall am I? I am 5'3 and like a few centimeters, something like that, so basically like 5'3. How old am I? I'm 25 years old, just turned 25 like 2 months ago, I think, so I'm starting to feel a little old. Honestly, I just want to set it back to 24 because I feel like last year didn't really count. So in my brain, I'm still 24. Where do I live? So I live in the United States for any of my international subscribers or followers. I live in California, been born and raised in LA, moved all around LA County area and stuff. So that's currently where I live, Southern California. I hate Southern California. I cannot wait to dip. When I went to New York, I absolutely loved it. So hopefully as soon as possible, I would love to move to New York. So that's the move. Am I in college? Have I gone to college? I was in college. I dropped out. I've never been that studious. I've always been the type of kid to like hurry up and get on the answer machine, which even saying answer machine makes me feel a little old. And I would like delete the messages of like tardies or misbehaving in class or like missed work and stuff. So I would forge my mom's signature on report cards. So I'm just never been studious. But I did give college a try, community college, and I dropped out. But I was majoring in fine arts, and then I also took a bunch of art history classes because I really enjoyed art history. I might go back just to finish it up and get a degree and not feel like I kind of wasted my time, but I'm still undecided on that. Do I have any siblings? I wouldn't say so. I know that's like a complicated question, but I was raised an only child, so that's all I know. And then the last question of like these basic questions to get them out the way first is, do I have a pet? And yes, I do. She's my dog. I've had her for like maybe 13 years now. Love of my life, my little baby, my little nugget. She's so cute. So yeah, I've had a bunch of pets over the years as well. So I'm very much an animal person. I love animals. So now on to the questions that my followers asked me. What are your favorite movies and TV shows? I have so many. Like, I have watched so many movies and TV shows ever since I was a little kid. Like, I was the only child, so I would be bored as f. So I would always watch so many things. So I have too many to name off the top of my head, but they'll be on the screen right now. It'll be some of them. But I just have way too many to answer that question off the top of my head. Favorite childhood memory? That's hard, because you know like when they say like you usually remember stuff from your childhood when it was like traumatic or something, so those are the memories that are coming to me. But a good childhood memory, I would have to say, was just anytime I was on a field trip. I loved field trips, like everything from like packing my lunch before all the way up to like being on the bus and the trip there and then enjoying the field trip, whether that was like going to Disneyland, Universal Studios. I don't have zoos now, but like the zoo, the aquarium, anything that got us out of the classroom, I loved. So I would have to say my favorite childhood memories would have to be anything at a field trip. I did get lost at Universal Studios one time, which was like low-key insane, but yeah, that's another topic for another day. Where are you from? So I kind of already answered this. Southern California, Los Angeles. What's your religion / belief, and if so, when did you start practicing this? I'm not very religious, to be honest, at all. But my family is very much Christian and like raised me Christian. So much so I went to a Christian academy. I had to wear like uniforms and everything and sing in choir and Bible study and all of that. I would say I'm not very much religious. I don't have really any religion I believe in. I would say though I'm very much spiritual. I believe in like energy and like entities, even aliens and stuff like that. So I feel like anything is possible. Honestly, how am I talking right now? How am I recording this video for you to watch? How am I breathing? How is this camera set up? How do we exist? How are we on a floating rock in the middle of nowhere? All of that constantly goes through my head every day. Every day I'm having like an existential crisis. So with that belief, I feel like anything's possible. But do I believe like there's sky daddy in the sky? Not really, you know, so to each his own. I should have prefaced this with saying no matter what your religion is, you are entitled to that. I respect anyone's religion. Also, love you too. What's your biggest inspiration and who was it when you were a kid? I honestly don't have any big inspirations or idols, and even as a kid, like I never really had an idol. Like I was never that type of kid to have like posters on my wall of people, whether that was like celebrities or even like family members or people I knew. I just never really had somebody I looked up to. I don't know if that's weird, but I just never was that type of kid, and I'm still not. I would have to say though, my biggest inspiration for anything creative would have to be like all of the media I consume, like movies and art and shows and all of that. Everything I've consumed ever since I was a kid, I just have like this like archived, curated gallery in my brain of any time I want to tap into something and get any inspiration for like creativity or my own art. I kind of just tap into my brain for that. I hope that answers that question. Self-love is a hard thing to grasp. Can you speak on that? I would have to agree that self-love is very hard, but how I see self-love is that it'll probably take your whole lifetime to do. I feel like it's a long, tedious process that goes day by day. And I feel like with self-love, whether that's like truly actually loving yourself, dealing with like depression, having like deep-seated insecurities, not tolerating how you're treated by others. So like self-love can mean so many facets to so many different people that I feel like it's such a broad term that you can't just like hit a peak and be like, wow, like I made it, I'm full of self-love, I'm complete, everything's fine now. I think there are days where you're gonna have so much self-love for yourself, and then there's gonna be days where you just might not have much. And I think that that's okay, and I also think that that's realistic, because in my mindset, if you feel like you have to reach this certain point of self-love to be an okay person, I feel like that's kind of setting yourself up for failure, because you're gonna have bad days, you're gonna have people coming in and out of your life, you're gonna have things come into your life and things happen to you that might not be the best. So it's always gonna fluctuate. I don't ever think that glass of self-love is ever gonna be completely full. So that's kind of my mindset about it. Even myself, I still struggle with self-love day by day and stuff like that. I do, however, feel like you can get to a place of having about enough self-love to not tear yourself down, and to also keep your energy protected from others and not tolerate certain things, and kind of have a little bit of confidence, or a little bit of at least self-assurance, I would have to say. I feel like self-assurance and self-love are very much connected and sometimes get confused with each other. If you do struggle with self-love and you want like more concrete answers, I would very much suggest like working on like shadow work prompts in your journal. And it's basically like questions asking yourself about kind of your flaws and also where they might have stemmed from. I feel like facing stuff that you dislike about yourself head on can really kind of solve and figure out or better adjust yourself to problems you have within, and practice self-love by doing that. I also feel like if self-love is something you really, really struggle with, like to the point where it's a little bit dangerous for yourself, I do suggest therapy. I know some people are very iffy about therapy, but honestly, going to somebody and having them have an outside perspective and not knowing you completely and giving you like an unbiased opinion about yourself and your actions and your self-worth can really change your mindset about how you view yourself, and you can look at yourself a little bit more objectively. I know that was a long-winded answer, but I would just have to say that is a lifetime process. It probably can take your whole life to work on self-love. So be patient with yourself. Also, don't beat yourself down too much. Give a little grace to yourself when you are doing things or how you view yourself. And yeah, so I hope that helps answer that question. Next question, favorite aesthetic. I have so many favorite aesthetics, like too many to count. So I'll just list them. I love like grunge, very core aesthetic. I love cyberpunk a lot. I love cyberpunk aesthetic. I love like vintage old Hollywood glam, like bombshell, a little bit of like pinup romance, if I can put that into one thing, aesthetic. And I also really love like anime aesthetic, and anything having to do with anime, I love. So I would have to say those are my favorite aesthetics. How old are you and are you single? I already answered this, 25. Am I single? Yes. Yes. OF. Odd Future? Is that what you mean? An anime character you identify yourself with the most? Great question, because I would have to say it's Alex Benedetto from Gangsta. She's my ultimate favorite anime girl ever, my waifu, someone I wish I was if I was in an anime. She's also on my phone case that I made myself. I love her so much. I wish I could gatekeep the anime Gangsta. I wish I could gatekeep it to myself because I love it so much. But I really love her character because in the show, she's been through a lot of traumatic experiences, but she still is super soft and empathetic to others. And there's just some quiet strength about her, which I just really love in an anime character. And also just look at her, like she's a bad bitch. I'm a bad bitch. That kind of makes sense, I think. What would you describe your aesthetic of clothing? I have so many different, like I said, aesthetics. So I would have to say, though, I love mixing like vintage with like postmodern clothes. I've been doing a lot of sustainable shopping. So I've been doing a lot of like online thrifting and just thrifting in person. So I do love a lot of like vintage clothes from like the 70s, 90s, even maybe a little bit of like 60s mod fashion I love, and kind of mixing it with like more contemporary clothes. I love mixing that, a little bit of minimalist. I love mixing that with like maybe like a maximalist top or like accent piece. I love, as far as like maybe clothing brands, Mugler. I love Mugler. Jean Paul Gaultier. I love Rick Owens. And I'm doing a little because some men love to gatekeep Rick Owens as if they're the only people who can wear Rick Owens in the entire universe. So anyways, love like old Vivian Westwood, like 90s Vivian Westwood. I love 90s Chanel, like when Karl Lagerfeld was there. Also, I like a bit of Margiela as well. Last question, what is your future career? My future career is just to be an artist full-time, a freelance one maybe, possibly, and also YouTube full-time as well. I would love that. I would love to be like a person who like curates exhibits, not exactly galleries, but like full-on immersive exhibits, installations around different cities. I know it sounds random, but I'm gonna put like pictures of what I'm trying to explain, of like the art I would love to do further down in my career when I'm more established, and just kind of like collaborate with cities to make it more lively, because I feel like modern architecture, especially in cities and metropolitan places, can look very drab and very sad even. And I just love seeing huge art pieces and spaces I can interact with. I don't even know how you even get into that position to be able to do those things, but I'm gonna figure it out, hopefully. So those are all of my questions. I hope this allowed you to get to know me a little bit better. If you do have any more questions for me, go ahead and follow my Instagram, and also comment down below if you have any more questions. I would like to do a part two, or like do more updated Q&A's in the future as well. If you did enjoy this video, go ahead and hit the like button and that notification bell to get alerts of when I have new videos. If you like that type of content and want to see it from me, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching, and if you got all the way to the end, thank you. I very much appreciate it, and I will see you guys next time.